I can't believe we walked up 100% of that sledding hill just to realize we forgot the sled. It's so cold out there. Let's warm up a bit in here before we head back out. Ooh, hot cocoa. Great idea. What's that? A letter for the both of us? Let's open it up.
Dear Justin and Mia, I have a question about percentages that I hope you can help me with. I've been using the 100 grid strategy to practice finding equivalent fractions, decimals, and percentages, but I think I've discovered a problem. I tried using the grid to help me write the fraction 1/3 as a percentage, but the grid can't be split into 3 equal parts. Is it possible that some fractions just can't be written as percentages? Looking forward to hearing from you, Max. Oh, that's a great question, Max. How can we convert 1/3 to a percentage without using a 100 grid?
Pause here to jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. While you think, keep in mind what we've already learned about fractions, decimals, and percentages. Do you have any ideas? I think we may have learned something in the last unit that could help us with this. You're right, Mia, the sledding can wait. Let's figure out how to help Max before we head outside again. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to convert between fractions, decimals, and percentages. That way, we'll be able to help our friend Max and finally get the chance to sled that big hill. Max wants to know if all fractions can be written as percentages or not. To answer his question, let's think back to what we've already learned about fractions. Mia, we already know you have a great batting average. How is that supposed to help us with the problem? Oh, that's right! In the last unit, we learned how to convert between fractions and decimals by calculating batting averages. Fractions, decimals, and percentages all represent part of a whole, so maybe this can help us with Max's question. Do you remember how to convert a decimal, like 4/10, to a fraction? 4/10 is the same as the fraction 4/10, or 4/10, which simplifies to 2/5. To convert decimals to fractions, we just need to create a fraction based on the decimal's place value and then simplify. How about going from a fraction to a decimal? Remember, the fraction bar represents division, so we can divide the numerator by the denominator to get our decimal. Let's try it now. Pause here to convert 3/4 to a decimal in your guided notes. After adding our decimal and a placeholder 0, 4 goes into 30 7 times. Bring down another placeholder 0 and 4 goes into 20 5 times. So 3/4 is equivalent to the decimal 75/100. But how does this help us convert to percentages?
We just discovered that the fraction 3/4 is equivalent to the decimal 75/100,
which we know can also be represented as the fraction 75/100. Since percent means out of 100, 75/100 is the same as 75%. Check this out. Decimal place values have a 100th place, which means we can use fractions out of 100 or our decimal place value knowledge to help us figure out percentages. Pause here to try it out. Using the place value chart, convert 67/100 to a percentage. After writing the digits into the place value chart, we can see that 67/100 is also 67 out of 100. Which is 67%. But what if we have decimals with digits in other place values too, like 5/10 or 1/25? How can we change each of those into a percentage? Pause here to try using the place value charts to convert each decimal into a percentage. If we write 5/10 in the chart, there's no digit in the 100th place. So, does that mean it's 5%? This decimal is 5/10, which in fraction form is 5/10. 5% means 5 out of 100, or the fraction 5/100. So we must be missing something. Oh yeah, we can add placeholder zeros to the end of decimals without changing the value. Aha, 50%. And that makes sense. 5/10 is the same as 1/2, and 50% means 1/2. So what about 1/2500? Filling in the digits in the place value chart shows us the percentage 125%.
But percentages are out of 100, so can we have more than 100?
We can. Similar to improper fractions, percentages greater than 100% represent having 100% of something plus another percentage of another whole, in this case, another 25%. Here's one more to try out. Using the place value chart, convert 738/1000ths to a percentage. Percents mean out of 100, but these digits go all the way to the thousandths place. What should we do? Well, we can think about this as 73/100ths plus some extra. So we can write this decimal as the percentage 73.8%. Or we can round our decimal to the 100th place, which gives us approximately 74%. It's up to you if you want to round your answer or not. So, we can use division to convert between fractions and decimals, and we can use place value to help us convert between decimals and percents. But we still don't have an answer to Max's question. How do we convert fractions to percentages?
As we learned previously, some fractions are less challenging to convert to percentages.
For example, we can shade 1/10 of a 100 grid, which represents 10%. Or we could multiply the numerator and denominator of 1/10 by 10 so that we get a fraction out of 100, which also represents 10%. But what about the fraction from Max's question? How would we convert 1/3 to a percentage? We can't split the grid into 3 equal parts, so the 100 grid strategy won't work. Is there anything we can multiply the numerator and denominator by to get a fraction out of 100? Multiplying by 33 gives us a denominator of 99. That's too low. And multiplying by 34 gives us the fraction 34 of 102, and that's too high. Guess we can't use the fraction out of 100 strategy. How about the place value chart? Would that help us? Unfortunately, we can't write a fraction in the place value chart. Wait a second. Is there a way we can manipulate this fraction so that we can write it into the chart? Of course! We could convert the fraction into a decimal. Let's try it. Pause here to convert 1/3 to a decimal rounded to the nearest 100th. Then use the place value chart to rewrite the decimal as a percentage. 1/3 converted to a decimal is 0.333 repeating, which, rounded to the 100th place, is 33/100ths. With 33/100ths in the place value chart, we can quickly spot the 100th place to identify 33 out of 100. So, 1/3 is equivalent to approximately 33%. As long as we convert the fraction to a decimal, we can just use our knowledge of place value to convert the decimal to a percent. Okay, let's write back to Max. Hi, Max. That was a great question. All fractions can be written as percentages. You may find it helpful to first convert the fraction into a decimal. Once it's in decimal form, you can use your knowledge of place value to locate the 100th place and determine the percentage value out of 100. Remember, practice makes progress. Thanks for your help today, mathematicians! Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities in your PDF so you can keep practicing your work with fractions, decimals, and percentages. All right, Mia. Are you sure you have your sled this time? Awesome. Keep crunching those numbers, mathematicians, and I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.